you sure you want to go through with this? You don't have to, you know. Daddy said so.
Don't you want me to remember? Don't you want me to remember how we met? The time we spent together? Our wedding day?
Yes, I do want you to remember all that. But it's after our time together that I'm worried about. Who you met, what you did, where you went. For all I know, there might even be another wife.
You think I'm a bigamist?
Well, maybe you just never considered our marriage really legal. After all, it was just a ceremony and signing of a paper.
Emily, I don't see how I could have married anybody else. Was I ever going to find anybody as pretty as you are?
I'm using a solution of thiopental sodium with anhydrous sodium carbonate as a base.
I still think it's the wrong thing to do, Neil.
Don't you want him to recover his memory, Leo? He's your son-in-law, whether you like it or not. Or are you afraid of something you might find out? Some dark patches in his past history?
Kirk's past is as much a blank to me as it is to him.
He wants the blanks filled in, and the patient comes first. Or so an old medical associate of mine used to say. A Dr. Galt, as I recall. I'm ready to begin. Would you bring the patient in, please? Take a few minutes for the serum to take effect. We'll try to create as restful an atmosphere as possible. Feeling relaxed?
No. You know, something tells me that Dr. Galt and Emily weren't too pleased about this whole thing.
That's one of the reasons I asked them to wait outside. We don't need their negative aura here, do we? Besides, as little distraction as possible is best. Feeling drowsy?
Yeah, a little.
All right, let's do a backward count. I start at 100 and count backward. Go ahead.
100, 99, 98, 97. I never could figure out what these things were supposed to do.
Well, it actually doesn't do anything at all. It just tells me where you are. Continue counting.
1997, 96, 95, 97, 96.
That's fine. That's just fine. Now, can you hear me?
Yes. Sleeping.
You're awake, you know. You're perfectly awake. All the drug has done was to relax you so as to free your mind from whatever restrictions it's imposed upon itself. You see, you might have built up a strong wall of resistance around your memory, and the drug is like the trumpets of Joshua, blowing down the walls. Okay, let's begin. What do you hear?
See, hear, voir. Dear.
What did you say?
True. It's the truth. I told them. I told the truth. They didn't believe me. God, why doesn't somebody believe me?
Guilty. 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 Guilty.
No. No, it's not true. It's not true. It's not true.
No, no, please don't. Please stop it. Take them off. Please. Take them off. They're burning me. They're burning me.
Come over here. Come on, I'm waiting for you. Come on, honey, I'm over here. Come on.
It's you.
Yes, Kirk, it's Emily. There's never been anyone but me. Don't you know that? I'm the only one who can set you free.
What are you doing now? What are you thinking about?
Oh, free. I'm free.
Free from what? Can't you tell me? Don't you know? Listen, I want you to open your eyes. That's right, open your eyes now. That's right. Now look at me. Look at me. Now tell it to me.
Can't. I don't know. I don't know.
You remember nothing? Nothing about what you thought or heard or saw?
Nothing.
Not a face, a name?
A name.
What name? Is it yours?
Kirk. Kirk.
Is that your name?
Kirk. Kirk. Kirk Michaels.
Emily, you have to be prepared for almost anything. If Dr. Wellman succeeds in bringing back Kirk's memory, well, you just don't know. Well, Neil?
I think I'd have to call the experiment a failure.
You mean Kirk remembered nothing about his past? Nothing at all?
Not enough to make any conclusive judgments. I was shocked by the amount of pain the drug produced.
Pain? I thought you said it wasn't going to be painful.
Not the sodium pentothal itself, but the feelings that it released in him. Whatever he went through in his recent past, it was a terrible experience.
But you have no idea what?
Well, I don't think that merely the concussion was the cause of the amnesia. See, I think it was both physical and emotional, a dual traumatic event. I think that the concussion merely gave his mind the excuse to forget something that was much too painful to remember. Emily, I'm sorry. I know you want your husband to know you.
It doesn't matter. It really doesn't. Kirk and I can make a new life for ourselves. We'll be together.